Hey everyone, it's Chaz. I promise you I have not been wearing this shirt for a week straight. I've just been filming a bunch of videos back to back. But anyway, in this video, we're going to be going over the solution to LeetCode problem 27, which is remove element. Let's read the problem. Given an array nums and an integer val, remove all occurrences of val in nums in place. It says the order of the elements may be changed. And then it says return the number of elements in nums which are not equal to val. So it gives us a little more of a description right over here. It says what we're actually doing is we need to change the array nums such that the first k elements of nums contain the elements which are not equal to val. And then we just have to return k. I think an example would help explain this a little better. So in this example here, I have an array that is 3, 2, 2, 3. The illegal value, the value that we don't want, is the number 3. So based on the instructions above, we need to change this array so that the 2 and the other 2 are in the front of the array. And then because there are 2 values that are not 3, then k should be 2. So we need to return the number 2, and then the array itself should be 2, 2, and then it doesn't matter what's after that. And if you look at the output here, that's exactly what it says. Output is 2, and the array itself is 2, comma 2, and then there are blank spaces at the end because it doesn't matter what goes there. You can end up putting anything there, and it won't affect your final answer. All right, so how are we going to solve this? We're going to do something known as the two-pointer strategy. What is the two-pointer strategy? Well, calm the down. I'm about to tell you. Let's start with an example array, and then our illegal value will be the number 2. So just looking at this logically before we start the algorithm, I see 8 numbers, and 3 of them are the number 2. So I need to remove those 3 2s. 8 minus 3 is 5, so I should end up with an array of 5 numbers. Those 5 numbers should be, hi Lucky, those 5 numbers should be at the beginning of the array, and then we should return the number 5. Let's look at our two-pointer strategy. We're going to start with 2 pointers. We're going to call them left and right. So let's put them on the screen. So I got a left pointer, which I'm going to show in red, and a right pointer that I'm going to show in green. So what these pointers will do, the right pointer, the green one, will be used to read values in the array, and then the left pointer will be used to write values or copy values in the array. Let's see how the algorithm works. So first of all, if we find the illegal value, the right pointer is the one that's reading the value. So if that right pointer reads the number 2, we're going to move the right pointer ahead and we're going to leave the left pointer in place. So in this case, the right pointer sees a 2, so we're just going to move it ahead and do nothing with the left pointer. And this makes sense logically if you think about it, because we're trying to get rid of the 2s, and we said the left pointer is going to be writing or copying values. So it makes sense that we would just leave the left pointer there because it's waiting to copy something. We want to overwrite that 2 with something else. So we're just going to leave it there while it waits for a value to copy. So now the right pointer is moved ahead. So what happens when the right pointer sees any other value, something that's not a 2? So if it sees any other value, we're going to copy the right pointer's value to the left pointer, and then we're going to move both pointers ahead. So right now, the right pointer sees a 1. 1 is not equal to 2, so we're going to copy that 1 to the red pointer. So that's what my array looks like now, and then we're going to move both pointers ahead. And this makes sense too if you think about it, because once we successfully overwrite that 2, once we successfully write a value with the left pointer shouldn't sit there anymore, because then it might start copying more values to that position. So it makes sense to move the left pointer over. And then with the right pointer, we don't want to keep reading the same value over and over again. We're going to read each value once. So it makes sense that both pointers move ahead in this case. Let's see what happens as we continue using our algorithm. The right pointer is currently looking at a 0. 0 is not 2. So when we find any other value, we copy the right pointer's value to the left pointer. So now 0 gets copied over to the left pointer, and then we move both pointers. Now the right pointer sees a 2. The 2 is the illegal value, so we're just going to move the right pointer ahead and leave the left pointer in place. So by now, maybe you can see what's happening with this algorithm, but let's just finish the array. So the right pointer sees a 3. 3 is not 2. So let's copy the 3 over to the left pointer, move both pointers ahead. Now the right pointer sees a 0. 0 is not 2. Let's copy that 0, move both pointers ahead. The 4 is not a 2, so let's copy that 4 to the left pointer, move both pointers ahead, and now the right pointer sees a 2. 2 is the illegal value, so leave the left pointer alone, but then move the right pointer ahead. So we move it ahead, and at this point, the right pointer is no longer in the array. So at this point, we're going to stop. This is the result array. I want to show you the original array by comparison. And we said at the start that we should expect to see the 5 values which are not 2 at the beginning of this array. So let's make sure. We have the 1, the 0, the 3, another 0, and a 4. So everything looks fine in that respect. The 5 values we expected are at the beginning of the array. Now, we were also told that we need to return that number, the number of values that are at the beginning of the array. So in this case, there were 5 of them. We have to return 5. So I want you to notice something. I'm going to put the index numbers of this array up on the screen just above their positions. I want you to notice that the left pointer is currently sitting just outside of the 5 values that we were expecting at the beginning of the array. And in fact, the left pointer is currently pointing at index 5 in the array. So we're going to take advantage of that fact. And when it says to return k, we're trying to return 5. Let's just return the index where the left pointer is currently pointing. All right, and now I just want to go over the time and space complexity of this problem. The time complexity is going to be big O of n, where n is the number of values in the array. And it's going to be big O of n because each value ends up being checked once. And then space complexity is big O of 1. It's constant space. And that's because we created a left pointer and a right pointer. And those two pointers will use the same amount of memory no matter how large the array is. And then that's really all we did. No additional memory will be needed to solve this problem. All right, so we figured out our algorithm. I saw the feedback on the last video. And I don't care. Let's code some Java. So here's the start of our solution. We're going to return an int, and the inputs are an int array called nums and an int called val. So let's start with our two pointers. Here we have an int called left pointer. We set it equal to 0, and then I put a comma instead of a semicolon so that I can now declare another integer. So I name that one right pointer, set that one equal to 0, and then I add the semicolon. So now I'm going to put the rest of the code on the screen, but we're going to go line by line. So here it is. We're going to start with the while loop. This is the block of code that's going to run over and over again until our condition is no longer met. The condition that I put in here was the right pointer must be less than nums.length. So in other words, the right pointer must still be within the array. As soon as the right pointer goes outside of the array, we're going to stop this loop. And then next, I have my if statement, if nums at right pointer is equal to val. So in other words, if the right pointer is reading the illegal value, we said we would move the right pointer ahead and leave the left pointer in place. So that's why I've got right pointer plus plus. We're going to move the right pointer, and we're going to do nothing to the left pointer. So what do we do when the right pointer doesn't find the illegal value, when it reads any other value? Well, that's what my else statement is going to be for. So if we find any other value, we said copy the right pointer's value to the left pointer. So we see down here my green arrow is reading a 0, so we're just going to copy that 0, just like that. And so that's what this line is. The nums at left pointer becomes equal to nums at right pointer. We just copy the value over. And then finally move both pointers ahead. So that's left pointer plus plus. and write pointer plus plus. We do this until the write pointer is pointed outside of the array, and then finally, we return the left pointer. And let's review why we did that again. Let's move that up. And remember, we said that when this algorithm is finished, the left pointer will be pointed just outside of the values that we need for our array. And in fact, that left pointer will be pointed at the index number that represents the number of values in our final array. So in this case, it's pointed at 5, so we just return 5. And that's why on line 13, I just say return left pointer. All right, so that's it for this video. Make sure you like, leave a comment. Oh, God, I got to write this down. Like the video, leave a comment, share it if you find somebody who wants to watch it too and they didn't watch it yet. Or even if they did, share it anyway. What's the other one? Subscribe. Subscribe, definitely. I'll see you next time. I'm going to write it down, I promise.